So it's exciting to know this is the 49th time we're doing these concerts. We're looking really forward to next year when we have our 50th. So that's not to downplay this one. 49 is pretty cool too. We're very excited for these concerts. The pop concerts every year are a really nice way for us to wrap up our musical year with a little bit of lighter, fun music for our band, chorus, orchestra, and modern band students. And our jazz students down here, who you're going to hear from first for sure, have been working on some really cool stuff. So thank you for being here. Aside from being a nice way for us to wrap up the school year and for us to say farewell to our graduating seniors, the POMS concerts are a very important fundraiser for POMS, parents of music students. I know you're all aware of that. POMS, over the generations, POMS has been really vital to the support of our music programs here in Belmont. And over the past several years, they've become more and more important to us as you know, the constraints of our school budget have been stretched in a variety of ways. We've leaned on POMS quite a bit more, not just for the extra special things like clinicians and jazz night artists and things like that, but actually for more operational things like staff for marching band and equipment and instruments and things like that, choral risers, things that we can't afford within the confines of our school budget. POMS really steps up. So a lot of what you see, you may or may not know, was funded by POMS, and I'm very, very excited to turn the program over to Mr. Ken Gable and the Belmont High School Jazz Ensemble.
We heard Chris on guitar, trombone, Aaron, so we're just doing one more piece for you. This is a Frank Foster tune, 4-5-6, and it's going to feature many people in the group. Who are we featuring? I gotta look at my cheat sheet. We're going to hear Rocco, Kina, Nate, Ali, Ryan, Sam, and Will again. So enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you. you all so much for being here tonight. It's such a pleasure to present this program. I look forward to the POPS concert every year. I think we can all speak to that. And it's just such a nice time to gather here and listen to some great music. I'm Caitlin Donovan, the choral director here, and that piece was an arrangement of the Lennon-McCartney-Eleanor Rigby by the Beatles, and it's been really fun to work on that in the past month. The next piece is a student selection every year around this time of year as we're entering pop season. I do a project with my students where we kind of talk about how we pick choral music that works for us vocally, that really like will challenge us, but also be vocally appropriate for our age in our group and our voices. And we see that it's more complicated than just picking a fun song. So we want to pick a fun song that also makes us think and work and listen and work well with each other and become more musical. So the student selection for this concert is an arrangement of the made popular by Adele song Skyfall from the Bond movie Skyfall. And this has really challenged us in a lot of ways, but it's been a favorite of ours. So we hope you enjoy the arrangement of Skyfall.
Thank you.
we do our final piece of the night with chorale, I did want to give a couple acknowledgments. The first thing I want to say is that this concert, in particular to me, is really special because it's my fourth year here, and so this senior class in general at the school, I have seen through, and I feel like I'm a senior right along with them. So I do want to acknowledge that we have one senior in concert chorale this year, and she has been there since I was a freshman too. So I just want to give a big acknowledgment to Gabby Mendoza, our cherished senior here. Sad to see someone though that's been there the whole time. I also want to acknowledge our wonderful collaborative pianist that works so well with us, and we are so lucky to have him, Mr. Matt Houlihan. Our final piece, this is a piece I selected, and I always tell them this story that I think is a cheesy story, but I enjoy it, and I think they laugh at me because it's nice, and I appreciate that from them. But my dad is the one in my family that's really gotten me to love music from when I was really young, and he always used to tell me the song Come Sail Away by Styx as he went to high school in the late 70s. He was like, if you go to a school dance, just be aware that when they play Come Sail Away, which they didn't play at my school dances, it's gonna start as a slow song, but then all of a sudden it becomes a fast song. So you need to be prepared for that if you're dancing and you think it's a ballad. It's gonna get fast, so you need to be prepared for that. I was like, thank you so much, I'll take that into consideration. They didn't play that at my mid-2000s dances, but I always remembered that, and I made sure to let them know that because it's a cool thing that we've worked on is having the variety within this piece, and it's been really fun to work on. It's been a really good time. We've had a lot of joy working on this piece, so it's fun to have the variety within it, and I hope you enjoy. This also features a small group with a lot of singers. You'll see the names in the program, and it also features a solo by sophomore Tabitha Kambasa. So please enjoy Come Sail Away and enjoy the rest of our concert tonight.
Thank you.
There will be a brief moment where we switch over the stage, so we hope you enjoy the rest of our concert, and we'll get orchestra ready to come on stage next. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us tonight for our Pops concert. Our next piece for you is a little bit of a medley from the Hamilton musical. We tried to have like a wrap-off competition in the orchestra, but they said we shouldn't do it tonight. So we hope you enjoy this version of Hamilton. You can like sing along and a little chair dancing's okay.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, our final piece for tonight as a concert orchestra here includes many themes from Star Wars, the iconic ones that you know and love. And without further ado, I will pass it on to Ms. Reed.
What Lucas isn't telling you is that I'm pretty sure from the first day he started playing the viola, he's asked me if we can play Star Wars. And it's true. And so now that he's at the high school, he has continued to ask me every day if we can play Star Wars. So I think if he persists with viola, which I hope he does, and all of our players do, we can have a little Star Wars fun every year. So The Last Jedi, which I have learned from these guys, is the 8th out of 9 movies. You will hear the most famous classic theme, and then you will also hear many new, refreshing ones. Do you want to give your conclusion? He put his notes away. So without further ado, according to Lucas, we hope you enjoy our Star Wars, and thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you. All right. It is our pleasure to present our portion of the concert for you this evening. Thank you all so much for being such a wonderful audience. Before we begin our portion of the program, though, I do want to sincerely congratulate and celebrate the work of the jazz band, the concert chorale, and the concert orchestra. Can we give them another big round of applause, please? We have three selections to perform for you this evening. The first one is a cornet trio. They'll be playing on their trumpets. This is by Leroy Anderson. It's called Bugler's Holiday, and it's a fantastic, joyful, light piece for this Pops concert. So our three cornet soloists, in order from left to right, Ryan Park, Ian Choi, and Brady Chan. Let's give them a hand, and here's Bugler's Holiday. We have a couple of instrument switches to do between Bugler's Holiday and our next piece, so I'll let our musicians take their places and get situated and do some sound checks. This next piece of music is on the slower side. It's much slower. It's a ballad It's called Blue and Green Music. Are any audience members fans of Georgia O'Keeffe, the artist? Great. Well, this piece is for you. The piece of art, Blue and Green Music by Georgia O'Keeffe, inspired this piece of music. So you're going to see the painting up on the projector as we're performing, and it's gonna go through different parts of the painting and kind of zoom in and move around, and it's a really nice way to celebrate this beautiful work, but also allow for the audience to be able to interpret what you're seeing through sound as well. So I think we're all ready. Can I have a thumbs up for everyone who moved? Can we do a quick sound check on the synth? Great. No surprises there now, sorry. And here is Blue and Green Music, composed by Samuel R. Hazo.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. For our last piece on tonight's program, we are going to perform a medley from the recent film Encanto. Ever heard of it? Yeah. I'm sure a lot of those tunes were very much stuck in your ears for many months when that movie came out. And for good reason, Lin-Manuel Miranda wrote an incredible film score, and this band arrangement is by Paul Murtha. We love performing this piece. It's been a favorite of ours since the fall. Actually, this was one of the pieces that we read down just for fun, and we decided let's save it for Pops, because that's perfect. So this is going to feature many musicians as soloists. We're gonna have fun and just make this a party, and if you wanna sing along or dance, go for it. Thank you very much. At least once a day, I have the best job in the school, and I am just so proud of every musician on stage and in the house. A couple of quick thank yous before we wrap up and send you off to a tasty reception. Thank you to Mr. Asadorian for constantly advocating for us and celebrating the music and visual art program here at BHS. Let's hear it for Mr. A. Thank you. My dear friends and colleagues, who I am just their biggest fan, Mr. Gable, Ms. Donovan, and Mrs. Reeby. Let's hear it for them, too. Thank you to Palms for sponsoring this evening's reception. Belmont Media Center, thank you for volunteering to film this concert so it can be available for you as an archive and to share with people who couldn't make it tonight. We cannot wait to do this all over again with some different groups and some of the same students mixed in tomorrow evening. We hope you can join us tomorrow night, same time, same place. Enjoy the reception, and thank you very much.
This is a really fun evening. Always, the Pops concerts are really fun because we program some fun, light music, celebrate the end of our musical year together. Tonight is a very special one because these ensembles tonight are where most of our seniors are. So we're saying farewell to our music seniors who have been with us, many of them since they picked up an instrument in the fourth grade or fifth grade. Some who have been new to us just over the last year or two here at Belmont High School, but it's a sort of bittersweet performance to end the year as we celebrate the music that we've made together, but also say farewell to some really special people and some special parents who have been with us for a long time too. So if you're here to enjoy your final performance at Belmont High School, we hope you'll soak it all in and really treasure it, and I think that you will. Another important thing that we do during the Pops concerts, this is our one ticketed event performance of the year, and that's because this is a really important fundraiser for Palms, parents of music students. If you've been in our program for a long time, you are well aware of all of the wonderful things that Palms does to serve our music program. You may not be aware that over the past few years, as budgets have gotten a little tighter, Palms has sort of shifted from providing us with a lot of the like really nice extras, like clinicians and guest artists and things. Now Palms is really relied upon to provide essential equipment and services for our students to make our programs work. Things like instruments and choral risers and pianos at elementary schools and things like that that we just don't have the ability to purchase within our school budget. Palms is there to pick up the slack. So that's really wonderful. Your tickets tonight help to benefit Palms. We also have several sponsors who have pitched in this year to help. The really wonderful thing about that is that means that all of the proceeds from your ticket sales will directly go to benefit students, and the sponsors are there to help actually make this thing work as well. We have one very special sponsor who I know is here today, and that's Dr. Murphy of Orthodontics of Cambridge. I think he's here with his family. They have stepped up very, very Thank you again to Dr. Murphy and Orthodontics of Cambridge. I am very, very excited for tonight. This is the first Pops concert where we're going to merge our modern band students with our band chorus and orchestra students. So you're going to be witness the history at Belmont High School tonight. It'll be really, really fun. And so, and then we'll have loads of more music happening in the cafeteria. We hope that you'll stick around after the concert. Palms has an incredible spread of desserts and cookies and little treats for you, and you'll have a lot more music to soak in out there. So, with that, I'm gonna beg you to enjoy this performance and soak it all in, and I'm very happy to introduce Ms. Caitlin Donovan and the Belmont High School Chamber Singers.
Just get through, you will be fixed.
And you think that I don't get it?
you all so much for coming this evening. It's great to see you. I look forward to POPs every year, and I think I speak for my colleagues and my students as well. So we're so happy to have you here together so quickly after our last concert. That last piece that we just performed was an arrangement of a piece called Secret for the Mad by Dodie. It's a commentary a little bit more about mental health, and we kind of can discuss a little bit more about like what it means to be a high schooler and what it means to experience the human experience. And it definitely can relate to all of us in different ways. So it was a fun piece to work on. The next piece is a medley of three songs from the stage musical, which was originally a movie musical called Once. It involves a little bit more folk music, which is a fun genre for us to explore. This piece features two soloists in our choral group, which is Nihara Thomas and Preston Clark, and we're excited to feature them. So please enjoy the Once medley.
I want you all the more.
Thank you again so much for joining us. I am so lucky to be here, and I'm so lucky to have this job and work with these students every day. It's just such a joy, and I was just talking to them about how this particular group of seniors is especially special to me. I feel like I'm a senior right along with them because I started the same year that they were freshmen, and so to watch their journey through music and through this school has been an honor, and I've just been so blessed to work with them. So I am so excited to bring you a final piece, and I hope you enjoy the rest of our concert and the reception. Thank you so much, Palms, for sponsoring that reception, and I'm so excited to hear our other groups perform. Our final piece is a fun arrangement of Africa. You can sing along, you can clap along. We hope you rock out Africa by Toto. Please enjoy, and please enjoy the rest of our concert tonight.
Thank you. That's called the F. Remington, and that's our daily warm-up. It is a pleasure to be here leading the wind ensemble this evening. My name is Allie LaCasse. I'm the band director here at BHS. Our program is very special. It's a lot of fun. It has something for everyone. I want to make a note, in case you're following carefully along in the program, we flipped our order. So we're going to start with Jurassic Park. and make sure all of our music is ready to go. And then we'll continue with Pie in the Face Polka, and then we'll end with the Duke Ellington medley this evening. We're gonna get going on Jurassic Park, and just to make people feel as old as I feel when I say this, we went to the movie theater 30 years ago in June and watched the first Jurassic Park, which is unbelievable to me. Yes, I love that energy. All right, so we hope you enjoy this beautiful medley of the film scoring of John Williams' Jurassic Park.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. What a beautiful arrangement of that piece, and it's so much fun to play, as you can imagine. This next piece is something completely different. There is a really fun piece of music by Henry Mancini called The Pie in the Face Polka. And this is an old piece from 1965. It is a ton of fun, and it features our entire clarinet section. And you are sure to smile and tap along to this really fun arrangement for band. So here's Pie in the Face Polka. Thank you very much. Before our last selection, I would like to congratulate and acknowledge some of our senior musicians, all of our senior musicians in the band program who are performing their last official concert at Belmont High School tonight. I have so many things to say to you, but I'm going to keep it very short right now and save the rest for rehearsals. But I'm just so incredibly proud of not only the musicians that you've become, but the human beings that you've become, and the You're going to go out to the world and become leaders, and you're already leaders, and you're going to make positive change, and I'm just so proud to be able to see that happen. And my only hope for you is that you continue being musical and performing after graduation and throughout your whole entire lives and looking back on your memories here at VHS with lots of pride. And I hope that we make you proud as you come back and watch concerts. So I'm going to read off their names and ask them to stand. Christopher Boyba. Lily Hicks. Ritvik Garg. Jake Matthias. Theo Moustakis, give them a wave. Jade Hicks. Andy Bello. Leo Carpenter. Luke Fitzpatrick. Rocco Cavalier. Nathaniel Gillette. And Daniel Parma. Your senior class of the Wind Ensemble. Bravo. We hope you enjoy Duke Ellington in concert.
Thank you.
joining us for our chamber orchestra. That was our one and only ballad of the evening from our orchestra players. And we are preparing next to play for you an urban concerto grosso. And you may be wondering, what does that mean? Traditionally, a concerto grosso has a set of soloists, and so they are the soloists. And then we have our tutti orchestra also with them. So our front stand set up here, we have Priscilla Lee, Subin Pio, Ora Kosar, Sam Maki, and Daniel Kim. They will be our soloists, our quintet up front, accompanied by our grosso, our concerto grosso. It's a little bit more of a grunge compared to maybe some Corelli that you've heard in the past. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you. joined by our wind friends, and we will play some How to Train Your Dragon.
Thank you.
so you know, this has been our mascot, Dorothy. Dorothy, join.
Come on up to the stage, and the rest of our band of friends join us once again for our grand finale. Check, check, one, two.
All right, well, this is the quietest a crowd has ever been before a Led Zeppelin show ever. So congratulations. That's way better. Okay, so this is the first ever collaboration of Modern Band. Well, you're gonna hear a lot more from Modern Band out in the lobby. There are 30 students in this class, and so you're gonna hear from most of them out in the cafeteria. This is the first time we've ever put this together. This happened because of Anthony, who's amazing. Anthony suggested about, I don't know, a month ago, like, wouldn't it be cool if we did a song with strings? Wow, that's a lot of players. Now it sounds like a Zeppelin show. Do we have the Hell's Angels on hand to work security? That was not Zeppelin, but we might need that. Okay. Yeah. Anthony had the wonderful idea that Modern Band should collaborate with strings, and we all thought that was a great idea. We kind of threw out some song ideas that would work, and Cashmere by Led Zeppelin was one that definitely lent itself to a collaboration with string orchestra. So when I was in high school, which was many, many, many years ago, this song was a song that we all loved in high school because it was like only about, then it was maybe 20 years old, and now it's hundreds of years old, still is relevant. But what I was thinking about yesterday was that when I was in high school, if I had said to one of my music teachers, hey, wouldn't it be cool if like a band and a bunch of rock band kids and the orchestra got together and did this Led Zeppelin song, they would have been like, yeah, that'd be cool, and then that would be the end of it. And I treasure the music teachers that I had growing up there, so that's why I'm here today. But I really feel like we're very, very, very fortunate here in Belmont that when, you know, we have a student that says, like, wouldn't it be cool if we did this, that we actually, like, have the ability to make it happen. We're also really fortunate to have people like Allie Lacasse and Margot Reavy, who when I go to them and say, like, hey, wouldn't it be cool if we did this thing in 2 weeks and tried to throw it all together, they don't come up with the excuses of why we can't do it, they just say yes. So I would love it if we would all thank them and everyone up here for just saying yes. I also would like to thank our principal Isaac Taylor. I don't think is here tonight, in our building administrators. But we talk a lot about the support we get for music education in our schools. Usually we're talking about funding and boring stuff like that. But we feel very supported by our administrators here when we go to them and say, can we have an hour to rehearse this all together during the school day? And they just say yes, no questions asked. They say, email their teachers, let them know they need to come down. To me, that tells me that they actually value what we're doing and they see this as important. They see it as important for all of your kids to be involved in this. So when we talk about support for music education in our schools, I think that's what it looks like, is when you have administrators that actually make it a priority and let that be a thing. So I don't know if they're here tonight, but please thank them for letting us do this and give them a lot of applause. So we rehearsed this once. It went really well at the rehearsal. It's going to go really well tonight. Mel Carullo is Robert Plant this evening. I think we're ready. Are we ready? All right, so here we go. Hang on 1 second.